Travers New Route Explorer plans the entire routes for you, and we're going to be evaluating their goodness by asking Travers specifically for climbs and trails. Now, there are plenty around where I live, but most of them are sorely underridden. Let's see if Strava can find them for us. We'll quickly go over how this feature works first. Open the app, click Explore, and then Explore Routes to open this new route creator. First, choose cycling as your activity type. Then specify your starting location, distance, and whether you'd like routes with more elevation or not. You can even choose surface type. Put these in and it'll give you three routes. You can then click on the routes for more details. You can see the elevation, how much of the route is paved or dirt, and it'll also give you an estimate on how long it'll take you to ride it. Let's go after climbs first. Since they are all on the outskirts of the city, I gave Strava 50 kilometers to play with and generated about a dozen routes. We'll talk about a few of them. First, we have a 52 kilometer route that covers both Kathraj Ghats, getting onto the Bangalore Highway for a bit before turning back. If you're in Pune, these are great climbs to get started with. Next, a 60 kilometer route that goes up Divya Ghat and comes down Babdev Ghat with 650 meters of elevation. These are both excellent climbs. Divya is like Kathraj at about 5%, but Babdev averaging at 7% can be quite a challenge. By the way, even though I chose 50 kilometers, the routes returned sometimes went up to 70 kilometers as well, so distance is not a hard limit. This 55 kilometer route is a beauty. Goes up Kathraj, then instead of returning the same way, it goes through some villages and takes you back through Babdev Ghat. I've ridden this route myself, it's not well known, but it's fantastic and includes some gravel sections too. Now this route starts out going up Kathraj Ghat and then full on trails, riding on the hill, getting lost, maybe running into leopards until you get to the other side, Babdev Ghat. But it doesn't end there. We get back on the road up to Kanifnath Temple from where it hits trails again, taking us to the bottom of Divya Ghat before sending you back home. Now this is a miss because there's a truly fantastic biking route from the temple to the top of Divya Ghat. As far as I know, the route that Strava suggests is a trekking route and you may have to carry your bike for a fair bit. Still, the fact that I was presented with this route by an automated tool is simply amazing. Here's another one. Starts on the same Kathraj Hill, but instead of going east to Babdev Ghat, goes west to Siyagad. Again, trails over the mountain. But this route is yet another trekking route. Taking your cycle wouldn't be fun. So let's stop here and take stock of how this feature has done so far. I asked for climbs and it gave me four great climbs in the city. What's missing, however, is the best climb of them all. Siyagad. Even the trekking route that it suggested doesn't go all the way to the top of that climb. It gave me a lovely uncommon village route and a truly epic over the mountains route across Ghats. But on the flip side, it also suggested trekking routes that aren't suitable for bikes. Let's see how it fares with more distance thrown at it. These are just the highlights at 80 kilometers. With 1100 meters of elevation, this 90 kilometer route gets three climbs in Kathraj, Divya Ghat and Purandar Fort. Quite a killer. It also gave us this variation that goes through Garade with slightly less elevation. Now here's a route that takes you halfway up Siyagad, but instead of continuing to the top, goes back down another way, then through the NDA back into the city. Now, unless you're in the armed forces, you're not allowed to ride through the National Defense Academy. And here's a variation of this route again, which is the trekking route, not a cycling route. So Siyagad continues to elude us for some reason. Let's move up to 120 kilometers. This takes you up Pabe Ghat, a short but killer climb, which in my opinion may actually be the hardest in Pune. And then up Kadbe Kind, one of the most beautiful climbs around. Now these are both fantastic climbs, but they are not well known at all. If you're interested, check the description to learn more. This Lavasa route is really quite epic. Not only does it take you up this famous climb, but instead of bringing you back the same way, goes down into the now dead Lake City and back to Pune through Panchet. And then halfway up Siyagad so that you can exit on the Bangalore Highway. You said you wanted elevation? This route has a whopping 2600 meters of it. Here's a variation which cuts out Lavasa for slightly less elevation. And finally, we're going to stick with Mutha Ghat but go north to Kamchet on route to Lonavala before returning back to the city. Now, I said I'll be evaluating trails as well. Part of the bad news here is that Strava surface detection is, well, rubbish. If you get into this route, this section is paved, but Strava says it's dirt. This section runs across the hill, it's dirt. Strava says unknown. And finally, on the other side, this part is paved again, but Strava says unknown. This isn't unique to this route. You'll find these discrepancies exist for most routes Strava creates. Strava sometimes presented nearly identical routes for both paved and dirt surface choices in the filter. So early on in this evaluation, I stopped using it. I also tried to get it to find me trails. For instance, Betal Tekdi, a hill in the center of Pune, has 20 to 30 kilometers of trails on it. Dozens, if not hundreds of riders ride here, and there are a few segments up here too. But the best Strava could give me is this measly route across the hill, even after several attempts. So pretty much an F for finding trails. So where does this leave us? Many of the routes that were suggested are downright fantastic. I've found a lot of these routes myself with a lot of research, poring over Google Maps and Strava data, or, well, bugging friends to share some of their best routes with me. But with this feature, I got a dozen great routes after spending only about 10 minutes with the app. Yes, you can't find trails, you can't trust a surface type yet, and sometimes routes aren't bikeable. But if you take the route they suggest as a starting point and do a wee bit of due diligence yourself, you're going to be in for a treat with dozens of new routes to ride. Kudos to the Strava team for delivering a feature like this, and I'm really looking forward to what they have planned next in the routes department. Now, did it show me all the awesome routes? No. For those, you have to subscribe to this channel and watch this playlist. Until next time, keep exploring. But maybe just online for now.